All right, so I'm currently on a mountain, and you guys might be wondering, Shaun, why are you on a mountain? Well, if you guys follow my Instagram stories or anything, you know that Chewy really likes to hike. And with the weather getting cooler, I've been trying to be better about getting outdoors and going hiking, taking him out. It's the middle of November, and I'm wearing a t-shirt and shorts, so the weather is just absolutely incredible. So I've been a lot better about going outside, going hiking, all that kind of stuff. I'm on this mountain that kind of like oversees the Las Vegas Strip. There's some parks down here that I used to play at growing up, and I could actually see my parents' house as well. So this is a mountain I used to climb and play on a lot as a kid. Anyway, the plan for today is to go down to main campus and get some work done. I need to do my UWorld questions, and I'm gonna work on a little bit of research. So I've been doing UWorld for the past week and a half or so, about 40 questions a day, and it is brutal, especially coming out of research, which was very collaborative. UWorld is very like isolating. I'm just like sitting there doing questions, and I'm spending like double the amount of time to review those questions. It's also very humbling because I keep getting a lot of those questions wrong, which is just so aggravating, but it's such a good learning tool. So it is nice to be going back and revisiting concepts and like learning things that maybe I had gaps in knowledge in before. And in terms of research, this past weekend, we actually submitted our first ever case report for publication, which unfortunately got rejected within like 5 days of submitting, which is totally fine. The journal was really nice about it. They said it was a really good case report. It just didn't kind of like line up with the kind of things that they published. They also published less than like 15% of submissions to their journal. So they said not to feel bad. They really liked the article and that they wish us luck on, you know, publishing it in a different journal in the future. Anyway, I'll talk more about UWorld and research a little bit later. Right now, I'm gonna finish this hike, go to my parents' house to pick up some laundry, and then we'll head down to campus.
Look how majestic Chewy is. He absolutely loves coming out here, doing some hiking, exploring the mountains. He just absolutely loves this.
Could I get a box combo, and then could I substitute my slaw for a sauce, please?
And then could I also get a box combo, and can I swap the coleslaw with extra toast?
Can we get Coke Zero?
Cool.
Do you guys have dog treats?
Here you go.
Oh, thank you so much.
You guys have a great day.
You as well.
Sorry, just take a bite. I would lose it.
I just look at her just dead in the eye.
Alright guys, so we just got back to my apartment. We went to go pick up some food and we ended up deciding not to go to main campus today just because we had like a last minute meeting come up over on this side of town.
Other side of town.
So yeah.
Just a lot of driving.
Didn't really make any sense. So we're kind of just at my apartment. We're going to independently do our UWorld after we finish eating this Canes. We're gonna work through our UWorld sets for the day and then we'll kind of probably take a break halfway through.
Yeah.
Get some coffee or something. Finish our sets and then review our questions. And that's kind of the plan for the entire afternoon. Alright guys, so we decided to take a break from studying and get some coffee from Dutch Bros, of course. But we were talking earlier about how much we're studying and how difficult med school is and everything that we're doing. And we were like, would we do this again if like we were given the option? Like, would we go back and do something else? And so we were kind of chit-chatting about it and we thought we would share that with you guys. So would you do med school again?
Yeah, that's interesting. I definitely would. So I had a different degree track, the whole everything lined up. Undergraduate major was in engineering. I had to reapply for medical school, so I was like, you know what, if I have to reapply for a second year, I'm just gonna do a PhD program. So my second year, I had applied for a PhD, I had applied for medical school, and I had actually agreed to the PhD program with the NIH, and I verbally agreed and everything like that, and then a week after I agreed, UNLV told me that they would let me in.
Nice.
So I was like, yes, super stoked. But I kind of did the unprofessional thing and told the incoming PI that I'd say, ooh, sorry, going Going to med school. He was great about it. I still emailed him like a few weeks later.
But you don't regret that at all.
I don't regret it at all. Med school has been a great experience. I'm really passionate about research, but I can still do it in medical school. That's true. Probably not to the extent that I would enjoy the other things inside medical school as well. What about you, man?
Well, before medicine, I was pre-physical therapy, as some of you guys who watch my videos know. But if I could go back and do something completely different that wasn't in medicine, it probably would have been like computer science or real estate. Like, I don't regret going to med school at all. Like, I wouldn't change that. Like, I'm super stoked to be becoming a doctor, love med school and everything. But it's like, if I had to choose something that wasn't medicine, probably would have been that, because I think my favorite moments in med school have been like the moments where we have a lot of autonomy, like the past month.
Like this break.
Yeah, we've been basically having our own time to work on stuff. So it's like, I wake up when I want to wake up. I work on practice questions when I want to. We've been working on research on our own time.
Yeah.
No classes or anything. We don't have to like show up to like anywhere. And I think that's something I'm going to miss when we go back to like having a schedule with like
strong structure,
really strong structure.
Yeah.
So I think I really enjoyed those things where like having my own time. And those are things I think I would have gotten out of like other fields that aren't gonna be medicine.
Yeah, I completely agree. It's been nice to be like, hey, like, what do you wanna work on today?
Yeah, and have that decision. Yeah. You're like, if I wanna sleep in and get more work done like later in the day, like, I wanna be able to have that option. So that's what I would've done instead, but I don't regret this. I love medical school. Like, we've grown so much. We've become almost like different people, I feel like, than like when we started. But it's just interesting to sometimes think about like, what would you have done? And like, you see your friends who are like, you know, in other careers and buying houses and buying cars, and you're like,
if you're in your mid-20s and you don't have a house and your squad is not talking about the stock market.
Exactly.
My squad is talking about, I don't know, what they had for breakfast this morning on their way to rounds.
Exactly. So it's interesting to think about, but I don't think either of us regret this. Like, yes, you spend a lot of time studying and it's tiring, sometimes discouraging. A lot of the times discouraging, and it's only gonna get harder. Like, we're like tired-ish, and we're not even like what would be considered the hard stuff yet,
We
haven't even started rotations.
No.
But it's such a great process. You know, at the end of the day, we're all gonna be 35 one day. And so
I think I speak for both of us. Like, we would both rather be 35-year-old doctors than 35-year-old PhD students or 35-year-old real estate. Do they even make it that far?
They're like millionaires by that point, so they just retire, right?
Yeah.
It's all about the long con. It's all about investing in yourself and really doing, you know, what you're going to be proud of yourself for doing, rather than, you know, being afraid or doing something different because you're afraid of how long it's gonna take. So we don't regret this, we're enjoying it. You make good friendships along the way, and it kind of makes the whole process just very worth it. Huh? What? What was that? I'm gonna watch it back later. Anyway, guys, we just wanted to share that discussion with you guys. But if there's any other like topics you want us to talk about in future vlogs, please let us know in the comments below. But for now, we're gonna get back to work. We have a lot of questions to do, a lot of review to do, and we don't have a lot of time because it's already like 5 p.m. So we're gonna get to work. But thank you guys so much for joining us in another vlog. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and we'll see you guys next week. I didn't get to show off Chewie's sweater. Look at Chewie's little Christmas sweater. It has Baby Yoda on the back.
He's so precious.
He's so precious. Look at him with his little haircut and his Baby Yoda sweater. He's so precious.
He looks like a little chihuahua. Chihuahua.
He looks like a chihuahua with his haircut. Yeah. Look, he's got these like giant ears, kind of like Baby Yoda. His ears are like bigger than his head. Okay, sorry for waking you up from your nap, buddy. Anyway, like, comment, subscribe. See you guys next time.